Many of you are telling me about your struggles with negative space, and this is video for you, and it's also a video for people, crafters who are just starting, who are beginners, because this is the simplest project ever. It's Asia Marquet here, Lemon Creation. Let's dive in. Let me, for the purpose of this film, imagine that you are a complete beginner. And let me just guide you through step by step, very, very easy project. This, in this case, it's an ATC card, but it could well be an art journal page, for example, or a scrapbook, a page on white paper or a lightly patterned paper. So, step by step, a very easy process. I started by cutting 3 pieces of paper. And for the purpose of this project and many of my projects, I'm using either mixed media paper, which is just here, or watercolor paper. Those are my two all-time favorites. I even made my own art journals with mixed media paper because I find it's the nicest one to work with. And so I cut them to ATC size, but as you know, you don't have to make ATCs, you can make just art journal page. And I know I'm kind of late with the explanations, the film is going and you know I am way behind it, but I'm gonna catch up right now when I'm actually doing my coloring. So I use ATCs, you can use art journal page, and if you want to start with negative space, the best way for you will be, you know, you have two options. You can either first start by adding paint, but I know this is kind of tricky because a lot of people are starting to add paint and they don't know where to stop. And that's why at the end they don't have this negative space. And for you, for those of you who don't know what negative space is, I didn't know at the very beginning, it's just the blank space, it's the white space, which gives also a lot of contrast to your creations, and which I love so, so much. So, as I said, starting with paint could be tricky. If you are afraid to start with the paint, choose your stamp. Either a background stamp, but don't put it completely on the background. If the stamp is, for example, in a very squared form, also try not to put exactly a squared form. Try to kind of not use maybe acrylic block and just make partial impression of the stamp. Or in my case, if you have a, you know, kind of funky flowers like that, you can add flowers like that or some other motif, you know, just on the side. It cannot be really a focal motif. Try to avoid things like stamps, like for example, a stamp of, I don't know, a person or a stamp of one flower, because then what can you add to this one flower as a focal point? Nothing really. So the best is to use backgrounds to make partial impressions of these backgrounds. Or like cluster of flowers, or I don't know, a cluster of some other things. Anything which can go well with your focal point, you can take think in advance about what your focal point is gonna be, and do not stamp on the whole surface, leave a blank space. Then choose your focal point. Very easy focal points are usually butterflies and flowers. You know, not very complicated, just one flower, for example, or one butterfly, or I don't know, a bumblebee. And you can color them. If you use a black stamp on the background, the best is to have a colored focal point. It's just for the contrast, it's easy. If you use a colored stamp, for example, with distress oxides or whichever other inks you are using, maybe try to add some kind of a black and white focal point. Once again, try to work on your contrast. So you have something which is popping up out, I think, from the page. So as you can see, I am using, these ones are my designs, my butterflies from the book I showed you like I think 5 minutes ago. And I am actually using water soluble oil pastels from Prima to color that. Or them, the butterflies. The butterflies are quite tiny, especially the orange one and the red one. It doesn't have that much blank space, so it was kind of hard for me to make the colors visible. And what I am doing is I'm actually putting a little bit of colors from the pastels, which are kind of, you know, thick and they stick to the surface very well. And then I'm adding a little bit of water on my brush and basically using it like watercolors. But of course with the pastels like that, soluble pastels, you can draw straight on the drawing or design or focal point, and then just move it with the wet brush. So the paint will react with water and it will just give you the effect of watercolors. But because the pastels are quite thick and my designs are so small, I decided to do it like that. But of course you can use whatever you want, you can use watercolors, whichever, sprays, magicals, I don't know, alcohol inks or alcohol rather pens, but you know, the simplest is to probably just use a focal point which is already colored if you are not very you know, strong at coloring, which I can understand because I'm not. But once again, what I want to emphasize is that you always need a contrast, you know, and don't try to overdo it. Also, I see sometimes people are complaining, crafters, artists are complaining that, you know, that they cannot manage to do the page they are happy with. They don't know exactly what I said before, how to use a white space. The thing is, yes, less is more. Like, you know, you can hear from, for example, Maremi Small Art. Don't try to overdo it. And don't try also put focal points in few places. Even if you have a big art journal page or a scrapbooking page, use rather a big focal point, which is just one focal point, and you just place it in one place instead of using, I don't know, five butterflies and putting them in four corners and in the middle. Because like that, your page will not look, I don't know, very balanced, I think, and it's silly, but it's not pleasing to the eye. You know, for your pages to be, your art to be pleasing to the eye, there has to be a kind of some kind of asymmetry almost. You know, the focal points in impaired numbers, so 1, 3, 5. Don't avoid or try to avoid like, you know, 2 or 4 focal points, you know, 4 butterflies, for example, on one page. Sometimes it's very nice also to put, you know, some of the, if you use, for example, 3 butterflies, to put one, for example, on the edge of the page and cut it a little bit, or let it stick, you know, its wings from the page. That adds a lot of also beauty to the project. Add the contrast wherever or whenever you can. Like in this case, you can see I'm adding, you know, the base black, which makes again the card, the ATCs cards to pop out. And there is another thing, not that many people are talking about, but when working on the project, either ATCs or art journaling or scrapbooking, there is some kind of invisible grill, which you don't see, and that's why it's invisible, but it's there. So basically, if you take a paper on which you are working, and you divide it with 2 horizontal lines and 2 vertical lines, you're gonna get these small crossroads, or rather, I don't know, points in which those lines are crossing. And those are the exact points where you, it's the best to actually place your focal points. So just stick to that and try to do it. And as you can see, if you draw this grid, there is nothing in the middle. Adding a focal point exactly in the middle is not a great idea, to be honest. It's always the best to use this asymmetry. So that's the small trick I learned, and I find it's really useful. Just to finish off the card and make it, you know, a kind of connection between focal points and the rest of the card, I added a little bit of splatter with the colors I used on the focal points, and of course a small sentiment. And I know most of those things for most of you are really evident, you know them, but I remember myself when I started, and here is the, you know, wink to those of you who are not sure about some things. I try to do it for really beginners, explaining everything as well as I can. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any comments and questions, please just write it down underneath the video. Thank you so much for subscribing, hitting the bell button to be notified about my upcoming videos. And of course, if you can share this video, I would greatly appreciate. And if you want to see some of my designs, there are also stamps and stencils and words. Please check the link to my shop down below. Thank you so much once again, and I wish you a beautiful day, and see you in the next video. Bye bye!